Last week, we spoke about opportunities to build new friendships through study and student associations. And the week before, about planning. Today, we are going to combine these two by talking about study-life balance. How do you combine your study with a demanding activity? We have two special guests. Bart Lukas studies industrial design and combines his strategic product development master study with high-level rowing. He participated 5 times in the World Championship and won a silver and a bronze medal. Welcome.
Thanks.
And we welcome Bram van der Veen. Bram is student industrial design and he combines his study with setting up a company that develops a care robot. Thanks for joining us.
You're welcome.
Bart, what does it entail to be a top sport rower?
Well, I'm part of the national rowing team. We compete in rowing competitions such as the national and the world rowing championships, and we train roughly 2 hours per training, 9 to 12 times a week, with races in the weekend during summer. In the winter, it's not always possible to go out on the water, so as an alternative, we work on ergometer or lift weights. In the spring, summer and autumn, the conditions are often better, and we train on our boats on the canal between Delft and Rotterdam.
So you spend about 20 hours a week on rowing? Wow.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh. How about you, Bram? Tell us about your company and how much time you spent on it.
Well, I made the external design of the care robot EVA 2 and the interaction behavior of EVA 2. In general, you could say I'm responsible for concept development and a part of the hardware development. EVA 2 was originally designed for the aid of senior citizens in residential care homes for moving about material and facilitating contact. Her predecessor, EVA 1, was designed with the thought of providing help for senior citizens at home, with tasks of daily life. Since the EVA 2 project has finished some time ago, I now spend less time on the project than my firm, but I used to work on EVA 2 about half a day per week. This is, of course, excluding the late night and odd times when new ideas pop up. And doing things like demonstrations and discussing with potential users often requires that you have to be present at times that often conflict with your schedule. You could say it differed a bit per week.
So how do you combine these time-consuming activities with your study? Can you show us your schedule for a typical week?
Well, I train before I go to the faculty and again when I'm done there. So you can see roughly what I do in my week in my schedule.
Well, during the most intense times of EVA 2, it simply meant doing small tasks late at night. It posed a challenge to combine it with my master and nowadays my thesis. Often I would meet with my team during lunch breaks or organize a meeting during dinner at someone's place. If you desire to work with 5 different people from 5 different faculties, a rigid schedule is not something that is feasible. So I'm sorry, but a schedule? I wish I could do something like that.
So what do you do to be successful in both activities?
I think the most important thing is to remain flexible and enthusiastic about both your work as an entrepreneur and your education as a student. And do not let negative statements from others get you down.
I work very hard every day and I plan and put aside some things other people wouldn't. In the end, the reward is nearly always worth the sacrifice.
Do you have any tips for students who have ambitions to combine their study with an activity like high-level sports or a job or a company?
Do it both. It's worth all the hassle.
Definitely do it. However, in the case of being an entrepreneur, I would strongly suggest setting clear deadlines and goals. These help you to keep your focus.
Thank you so much for joining us today.